Hey there, welcome back to the channel. If you have been looking for a way to send invoices to your clients through your Squarespace website without having to pay extra money to do that, I've got great news for you, and I'm going to show you how you can do that in today's video. But before I do, if we haven't met yet, my name is Meg. I am the founder of Floating Lotus Design. I'm a Squarespace web designer and unabashed tech nerd, and my joy is in helping you to elevate your business and website without the tech overwhelm. Well, I'm really excited to be able to share this quick update with you today. You can now send invoices through your Squarespace website at no extra cost. It's not an add-on to your existing plan. It is free for all plans. And yes, that includes personal plans as well. So this is a big deal. Usually there's add-ons for things like this. So the ability to create simple, easy invoices and get them off to your customers without having to leave your Squarespace website is going to be really great for a lot of you. So let's head over to my demo site and I'll show you exactly how it's done. All right, so let's take a quick look at how to create an invoice in Squarespace. Once you are logged into your site, you'll see over here on your left-hand main menu navigation, you'll see invoicing. Again, invoicing is available on all of Squarespace's plans. It is free, it's no extra charge, so that's a really nice little thing they've done there for us. So you will find the link to going to invoicing right here on the left-hand side of your main navigation. So we'll just click on invoicing. And that will open up this panel, which looks like it's got a whole lot going on. They've given you multiple places to do the same thing, create an invoice, learn more. You can create over here, you can hit create down here, and you have a nice little dashboard here to show what you have once you've sent invoices, quick to see what you have for revenue paid and what's outstanding. Before we create an invoice, I'll also go over here. You can convert leads to clients. So if you've had form submissions with folks that have been interacting with your site and you want to turn one of them into a client and invoice them, you can view here your contacts. You can also view them up here and, you know, turn them into a client that you can send an invoice for. So pretty straightforward. I'll also call out here, you can create from up here by hitting this create button. One thing to notice here is there's more options than invoicing here. There's proposals, estimates, contract, and projects. That's a whole different ball of wax, and I'm not going to go over that in this video today, but I will go over that in a future video. So we're just going to concentrate on invoice. So you can click create an invoice from here, or I'm just going to click right here. Now, you can start by selecting an existing client, adding a new client, or if you just want to run a test, you can add yourself as a test client, which I've done here. And once we hit continue, it's going to bring us to the invoice interface. Again, not super fancy. It's not going to be like incredibly like fancy designs or anything else. It's a really straightforward, no bones invoice setup. But you'll see right here, you have the name of your company. If you have a logo, that would show up here. It'll give you the invoice number and then a message. So this memo you can find over here and you can adjust whatever you want that message to say for your invoice in that spot there. You then have the summary of the invoice. So if you want to add your order summary here, we're going to click add a line item. Let's just say for fun, we're going to do a custom Squarespace website. It's a service, not a physical item. It's going to be one, and we're going to put $3,000 in here. Okay. And click done. And you'll see that that automatically updates your invoice. And it will have the bill to me, my email address, and the details down below. What else can we do here? Well, I can change over here in the content, the due date. So I have due upon receipt, or you can select a date, but you have to click off due upon receipt if you want to select a specific date. So I'm going to select July 1st. And then if I wanted to apply a discount, you can apply a discount here as well, either in a percent or a dollar figure. So very straightforward there. And that's pretty much it. When somebody gets the invoice, they can click the pay invoice to pay their invoice, which I will go over in a moment, some requirements you need to have there. But before we dive in on that, I want to quickly go over style. So right now, see, this has kind of like a pale bluish gray background and a basic, you know, white and black invoice. I can change the style, which is going to be linked to
global email styles. So anything you change here will have a global impact on those things. But if you click in here, it will bring up the editor page and you can change the background and fonts individually, or you can quickly match your site. So if you click through here, you can click a theme. I have theme one. You can go through here and it's going to automatically apply a theme based on the site styles that you already have set up. If you want to add a logo, it's going to pull your logo over. If you have a logo set up on your website, it'll automatically pull that over. So that's just quickly how you can update the formatting of it. But again, it's pretty basic. So head back to the invoice now that I'm happy with it. Next thing you would do is just hit send if you're ready to send it off, or if the event that maybe you're doing your end of month billing or something like that, and you're going to create multiple invoices, if you don't hit send, you can hit back and it will be saved as a draft. Here you can edit it, preview. You can delete it if you decide you're not going to need to change that. Preview, that just again gives you a preview. You can see what it looks like in a mobile view versus your desktop view. And if you go back, if you need to make any edits, or you're ready to send it, you go in here and then click send. Now, key thing I want to point out, in order to be able to use invoices in Squarespace, you obviously are wanting people to pay you and have your money come into your account. So in order to do that, you must have your payment processor that you use, whether that's Squarespace Payments, Apple, Stripe, PayPal, whatever it is. You need to make sure that you connect your payment processor account to your Squarespace account first before you send any invoices. Otherwise, when people do hit that pay invoice and they try to pay you, it's not going to work. So just keep that in mind. And so that is pretty much it for invoices. Very simple interface, very simple reporting. You don't have payment plans on here or anything else like that. It's just very basic setup. It's nice that it's free. And I think that it would be good for folks who don't require anything fancy or have really complicated workflows. It should work very nicely for you if you don't require anything more advanced. It's certainly useful and a nice addition to the platform. So there you go. I think this is a great new feature that Squarespace has added. It is basic, it's no frills, but I think for a lot of people, it's a great way to get started and be able to track your invoices and make it simple for both you and your customers. Let me know if you found that helpful. If you have any questions, hit me up in the comments. And if you like this content, please hit subscribe so that you will get to see new videos as soon as they drop. And if you'd like to hear more, be sure to grab the link in my description and sign up for my email list. I'd love to have you there. I not only share the latest videos, blogs, but a lot of other resources, tips, tools, tricks, and insider stuff from my design world that I share only with my email list patrons, if you will. So if that is of any interest to you, please go ahead and sign up. I'd love to have you. And until next time, thanks for watching.